Queenslanders go to the poll on the 26th of October, only 38 days away. Premier Stephen Miles, the giggling goose we like to refer to him as, has been pretty busy buying votes, promising to keep 50-cent public transport fares and free electricity with $1,000 rebates on power bills. He's also spending plenty of time on social media, releasing these carefully curated videos, popping in for a cuppa with a voter this morning. Have a look.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi, I'm Stephen.
Great to meet you.
Great to meet you too. We brought some buns and things.
Cup of tea.
Yeah, I'll have a cup of tea. This is a lovely spot. Dora?
Yeah.
Beautiful house.
Show us these flowers. They're beautiful.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're going to build more of these, more units like this.
Are you?
So, yeah, it's great to see people liking them.
Who wants politicians barging through the front door for a cuppa? Let me bring in former Queensland Premier Campbell Newman joining me on the desk here. Good to talk to you, Campbell. Is he going to get away with it? This bloke's handing out money. It's so blatantly trying to buy votes. I know the 50-cent public transport fares have been a real winner. A lot more people using them.
Yeah. Look, I think it's actually helping move the needle for him, to be blunt and frank about it. I don't know that it will rescue him, though. In fact, I don't think it will. But, you know, they are working very hard. They're very effective. And I think the sort of slightly awkward, well, do I say daggy dad persona, in my opinion, actually works. It's not threatening. I think the 50-cent public transport fares, $1,000 electricity giveaways is also resonating as well with the people he needs it to. I mean, I've got a credit on my power bill now. You know, I can't jump over. I won't be paying electricity bill for ages.
It's such a false economy, though, isn't it? We've got expensive electricity. Yeah. We're pretending it's cheap by throwing government money at it. And the important thing is, tell me, David Crisafulli's not going to get rid of any of this. You still got your 50-cent bus fares and you still get this $1,000 rebate. So in the end, there's that small target strategy work for him? Are people going to take the cash from Labor and still vote LNP?
Well, I guess we'll see soon. I think it's quite a dangerous strategy because, you know, for months now, David Crisafulli's been saying, well, if we're elected, we'll do that. Oh, we agree with that. I'll adopt the budget of the Labor Party. And I think for many of us, that's, you know, a pretty dodgy sort of way to go about it. But importantly, when you suddenly become the Premier, where's your mandate? Where's the vision? Where is the authority of the people to actually make difficult decisions? And you know, Queensland's going to need budget repair because the coal royalties are going to drop off a cliff soon.
So you're saying he's not levelling with people about that economic challenge at hand?
Yeah, I'm afraid so. And, you know, take the 50-cent fares, right? It costs, I saw some figures recently, it costs about $19 to supply that trip, $19 of Queensland taxpayer money to provide the 50-cent trip. So we're going backwards at a rate of knots. Meantime, we've got the Bruce Highway, which is a highway of carnage and death, which arguably, rather than everybody getting such a freebie down in the south, I mean, it might as well be free for, you know, in public transport in the southeast of the state. You know, we've got a road that needs to be fixed and, you know, government's about allocating resources, Chris, you know that. And you know, my view, you know, people should be paying, you know, a fair price for public transport, but we should be fixing the Bruce Highway.
Well, it'd be probably cheaper to make it free. It probably costs more than 50 cents a fare to actually run the fare system. Tell me about crime. Obviously, it's a big issue, especially in certain parts of Queensland. Is it going to shift votes and where?
Look, it will shift votes in certain areas. I mean, the crime problem now, the youth crime problem's right across the state. But I think where it has particular resonance is in Townsville, for example, and some of the regional cities, Cairns as well. You know, there's three seats up for grabs in Townsville. The LNP, by the way, have got to win, you know, at least 12 and retain Ipswich West, by the way, which is not necessarily going to be the case. They should, I think. So, you know, there's three up for grabs in Townsville. There's Cairns, Barron River. So that's a win there. I think in the Bayside of Brisbane, we've got a candidate there with the LNP, who is the father who lost his young ones there, you know, in a terrible, tragic accident. Well, not accident, when a young driver who was drugged up and drunk had killed them, you know, a young couple. So I think he I think he's going to be the next member down there.
So your summary is that there will be a change of government, that Labor will lose, but perhaps not as emphatically as people think?
Well, I think Labor's going to lose. I've already said that on Steve Price's show on this network. The challenge is that the Labor Party have got a lot of money and it's from the unions because they've rigged the election rules so that the unions can all spend significant sums of money, and on the right of politics, you don't have, you know, similar organisations lining up to take advantage of those rules and run these so-called third-party campaigns. So, you know, I'm disappointed the LNP have chosen to be a small target. I think a bold, you know, brassy sort of policy going out to Queenslanders and telling what they would do in office would be rewarded in these times.
I think you did it.
We did.
But you only lasted one term.
Yeah, but we did it and we were rewarded. And I think David Crisafulli would be rewarded and the LNP would be rewarded if they said that. They would win as big as 2012 if they did.
Thanks for bringing your insights to the table, Campbell. Thanks, I appreciate it. Fascinating to watch.